Thank God you're all right. How did you get here?
It wasn't easy. At least I haven't had any more episodes.
I wish I could say the same.
Hey, I think I might have found us some transportation.
This thing gonna run?
Only one way to find out.
Shit!
What are you doing? Answer me.
Alright, my friends, welcome back to my Akumu difficulty walkthrough for Evil Within. This is chapter number 12, The Ride, and we start off this chapter by being chased by probably the most random monster in this entire game. I don't know where it came from, I really don't. But nonetheless, we have to escape him, and we should start by shooting him with a shock hole so that we can stun him, and then quickly shoot him twice with a sniper rifle in his face, and that should be enough for him to stop attacking us. This monster has essentially four types of attacks. His first attack includes him using one of his legs to try and pierce through you. Another one is he does like a sort of pincer attack from both sides, but if you're close to the driver's seat, you won't get hit by that attack. He also has that attack where he uses a leg to make a move to the right and then to the left. You need to dodge to protect yourself from that attack. And he also has a very annoying attack where he actually attacks with two of his legs and then he drags them across the bus. And I think that to dodge that attack you actually need to move closer to him. And if you do that, then you should be alright. Just make sure you duck.
I don't know how long we'll be safe here.
Chances are, Kidman, that we won't be safe for long, especially after you said that. Because it's not like we really can catch a break here. Okay, so this is a pretty difficult section, I feel, for this chapter. However, there's a strategy that you can use that will make your life a lot easier. There's one problem with this section, and I'll show it in just a while, because I'm sure it's going to happen, since it happens all the time. But what we're going to do before the haunted with the sniper rifles appear in front of us, or in the structure above us, we're just going to help Joseph shoot a few haunted. I'm going to shoot that one with a sniper rifle. Be very careful with the guys with the sniper rifles, because as you know, they fire very quickly. And I'm just going to shoot that guy as well. There we go, he's down. And now the other haunted with the sniper rifle should be appearing soon. Yes, here they come. So it's time to go into hiding. So what we're going to do is stay in this area of the bus. As you can see, the ceiling is left standing. So the sniper rifles that are standing in the area above us, they won't be able to hit us. So we're protected here. The only thing that we need to worry about is the haunted that appear directly to the side here. Those ones can still hit you, and be very careful with the ones that walk inside the bus with the dynamite stick. Shoot them quickly, use your sniper rifle or shotgun to blow the dynamite stick. One sniper rifle bullet will kill them, because otherwise they will throw the dynamite stick and you have to dodge by moving forward, and I can guarantee that you'll be shot either by the dudes with the sniper rifles or the dudes with the machine guns. Now this is a very annoying section, be very careful here guys. As you can see, when the Haunted with machine guns appear, there's a small cutscene where you can't move at all and you're forced to look up. But that gives the Haunted that walk inside the bus with the dynamite sticks, they don't stop moving, so they will move close to you while that scene happens. So you need to be very careful. It's clearly they didn't think this through, and it's clearly a gameplay mechanic that's messed up, because you can die if that Haunted throws a dynamite stick, or if he runs at you with a dynamite stick in its hand, and you won't have any time to react because you physically can't move, or Sebastian can't move while that happens. So be very careful with that cutscene, because you need to shoot the Haunted as fast as possible, otherwise you will most likely die, and it won't really be your fault, it's the game's fault. This is one of those situations where you can blame the game. This is one of those situations where you can blame the game, because they didn't clearly fix this issue, and it can be very frustrating. That's why either use the sniper rifle or the shotgun to take care of the Haunted with the dynamite sticks as fast as possible. Because like I said, if they throw the dynamite stick at you, you have to run to the end of the bus. But that leaves you wide open for the Haunted with the machine guns and sniper rifle. And in Akumu difficulty, they're not going to wait to start firing at you. But you can, as you can see, you can pretty much stay there in hiding and let Joseph and Kidman do most of the work for a change. Also be very careful, I didn't sort these two perfectly well. You should actually wait for the whatever that is to finish its attack with its leg, because if you stun it with a shock bolt while its leg is coming down, the camera will actually be stuck again and you'll be forced to be looking up, which makes it harder for you to shoot at it. Always remember that when he starts wiggling himself, he's going to release those parasites or whatever, and you need to throw a grenade because it will dispose of them. This is the double claw attack that I was talking about. Move closer to the boss, use a shock bolt to stun him, and if you stay here, hopefully you'll be okay. I can't quite guarantee that this will work, but this attack is incredibly stupid in my opinion and hard to dodge. But use a shock bolt to stun him if you see that he's going to use that attack, and then try to do what I did and hopefully you'll survive. But you really don't need to worry about this guy anymore. Problem solved. And I really don't know how I feel about that enemy. He just really comes out of nowhere, and he has a humanoid face, but then spider legs. It's, I guess they were trying to make him look creepy. He looks like a really dumb boss to me, and he acts like one too, as we're about to find out.
I got you now.
Womp womp womp.
Where are we heading, Joseph?
I've got a theory. We seem to be moved around an awful lot. Almost as if by someone's will. So it's nearly impossible to get any sense of the geography around here. But the light, Beacon Mental Hospital, it's always in the distance. This thing you found me hooked up to, I've seen it in more than one place.
Yeah, so have I. It seems like it's the same exact one, but it's hard to be sure.
The thing that I've noticed is that each time I run across one, I seem to be closer to the lighthouse. It could be a coincidence, but like I said, it seems as if there is some intelligence behind it.
So you figure we ought to cut to the chase and just head straight for the hospital?
Exactly.
Nice work, Detective.
The right side looked like it led more directly toward the hospital.
Joseph, no!
Just get us out of here!
There's an ambulance there. There might be some kind of first aid. I'll go.
No, I'll do it. Don't let any of them on board.
Okay, so it's time to save Joseph yet again. We need to get a blood pack. And this section can be somewhat tricky. There's a bunch of haunted guarding this area. So I'm going to try and create a little noise here, and hopefully my strategy will work. I'm going to throw that bottle over there, and then I'm going to use a flash bolt while the haunted all gather around to inspect. I'm going to throw a flash bolt to blind them, and then I'm going to shoot the barrel, and hopefully that will... Scratch that, I'm not going to do that, it's time to improvise, and oh boy, they're all coming after me, but guess what, idiots, there's a barrel there. So, they really didn't think this through all that well. Okay, so my initial plan, clearly, as you guys saw, didn't work, but sometimes you have to improvise, and that was clearly one of those, this was clearly one of those situations, but apparently it worked out just fine. You don't want to wait for the haunted to get too close to you, because most of these haunted have handguns and they will open fire as soon as they see you. Let me see if I can lure a few more. Oh, there's one coming. So I'm going to try and make her follow me so that I can burn this barrel here as she's coming through. There we go. And there should be very few haunted left by now. There's a guy with a sniper rifle, which I recommend that you kill. Alternatively, you could use a bunch of flash bolts, throw them to the ground, and just make a run for it. I wouldn't recommend it though, because the guy with the sniper rifle, I think he can still shoot you, so I wouldn't risk that. But this seems to be working pretty well. I'd rather be safe than sorry, so I'm going to take care of that guy with the sniper rifle there. That clearly alerted the other haunted. Here it comes. Oh, there's another one. I'll flash bolt and I'm gonna stab you. There we go. Is there another one? Oh, there is one left. Let's see if I can stab him. There we go. And that takes care of all the haunted in this area. There's one more, I think. Be careful with this bear trap right here. That's another reason why you should really be very careful if you run forward. If you get caught in that bear trap, you will die on Akumu difficulty. And there's the last guy, hit the barrel, and there we go. No, you shall not throw dynamite at me, sir. Good day. Now we're going to pick up the only collectible that's present on this chapter, another map fragment. It's right here. Now pick up the blood pack, and now this next section, we'll see if we can make it work. This guy has terrible aim though, so we should be good. So we need to shoot the guy using that machine gun there. It's kind of tricky to shoot him, but you should shoot him right between the machine gun and the MV, and if you do that, then you should be able to shoot him in the belly and he will die. Now, as you can see, there's a lot of haunted here, a lot more than I would have hoped. Let's wait for them to follow Sebastian, and flashbolt blinds them all. And now, oh boy, it's Arnold Schwarzenegger time. Just shoot everything that moves. And the good thing about this machine gun, that it doesn't have any reload or cooldown period. You can just shoot like crazy and shoot everything that moves. It's really an interesting weapon. Now, after we kill a couple of waves of haunted, we will have the opportunity to head inside the bus. So be ready for it. What you need to be really careful with is the policemen that come with the machine guns. But if they open fire, a single bullet will kill you, as you know. But after this wave, it's time. Get to the bus! That was my Arnold Schwarzenegger Predator impression. I know it hit someone, I'm sorry. But I just had to do it. I just had to. and we save poor Joseph's life again. But he's a cool guy, so he deserves it.
Shit.
Okay guys, so now we have a trophy to obtain. I already obtained it on my survival difficulty walkthrough, but if you don't run over any content in this section, you will gain a trophy. And it plays out in Akumu difficulty precisely in the same way that it plays out on survival difficulty. I dodged that guy barely. But if you move your buzz, the buzz in the same direction as I'm moving it, you'll be able to dodge all of the content. And this concludes this chapter, my friends. I hope you enjoy this episode, and I'll release the next chapter soon. Take care. Oh, of course he had to spoil our fun.